This afternoon on Be Something Wonderful, how to surrender. Yielding to versus going against the flow of life. This is Tom Kieran with the Be Something Wonderful studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Welcome back, creators. I've got a great lesson on surrender. We've talked a lot about surrender and acceptance, but I want to talk about it like we've never talked about it before. And a lot of this comes from the power of now, from Eckhart Tolle, but really, as I always talk about, every spiritual teacher talks about the idea of surrender or acceptance. What does it really mean? Well, let me tell you what it's not. It's not about giving up. It's not about giving in. It's not about being passive or not caring anymore or being lazy. None of that, right? This is not what we mean by surrender. Okay, I surrender, I give up. Do what you want. That's not what surrender is. This is the confusion. That's the ego talking. That's the ego mind, that rational thinking mind trying to define something that's very spiritual. It's really about letting go and letting God. It's getting the backup, getting the help of God in the universe and infinite potential and the infinite intelligence of the universe, right? If you don't surrender, you're going against, if you go against this power, then you're working without it. You're going alone and using your own physicality, your own physical existence to get things that you want in life. You may get a few things, right? You may be able to whip up some scraps. Even if those scraps turn into like millions of dollars and big businesses, it's going to cost you in the end, guys, because going with the flow is that inner being. It's that inner power. That's where all the power is. That's really where life is. So it doesn't matter what you do in the external world, what you accomplish or what you pile up in terms of belongings and trophies and things that you want. If you're not connected with that inner being, if you're not connected with God, what's the point, right? So let's talk about this. It's really accepting what is. This idea of what is. This is what Byron Katie talks about a lot. In her book, Loving What Is, but in her life, right? All the ancients, all the greats, Jesus, they all talked about this idea of accepting, getting into the power of now, where your divinity is, where your divine presence is, where that infinite power and potential is. And letting go of all resistance, this inner resistance, right? Even if there's a scrap of resistance in you, that inner resistance or that unconscious resistance is always going to come up. You've got to let that go. It's essentially, guys, you're reconnecting with God. You're reconnecting with that source. Surrender really is about inner transformation. It has very little to do with the outside. The outside will fall into place. Things will get done. People will show up. Events will happen once you surrender on the inside. It's not giving up to an external situation necessarily. It's that inner surrender to let God in, to let that power take over through you, with you, through you, right? Not in spite of you, right? It can't go in spite of you because you are that flow. So it can't do it without you, right? You can still take action. This is a false belief. This is a bogus belief of surrender about, okay, I give up. I won't take any action. I'll just sit here. It's not about that. It's taking action, but first surrendering. Then it's divine action. Then it's God action, right? Then it's God-inspired action. That's the difference, guys. Recognize that you want to change an undesirable situation. That's okay. By putting your attention in the now, it's getting back into that now, into that divinity. It's okay recognizing that this situation is undesirable to you, right? And then wanting something else. This stuff happens, right? And in life. But it's what gets us into more problems is we try to, we react from resistance, which makes it harder, which puts up obstacles, which blows the problem or the situation into a bigger problem, the situation. Or we think we've resolved that and other things start popping up that are negative and that shows that resistance. So don't judge, don't resist, no negative emotion. Surrender first and then. That's really a key in life, guys. That's really the key in everything. It's what Abraham Hicks talks about, get aligned and then. right? Get God and then. This is the idea. Line up with God and then. That's what surrender is. It's getting that God power. It's lining up with that. It's aligning with the best part of you, that higher, wiser, greater part of you, and then taking action. Whatever that action is, it will come to you. And guys, it will be flow. It won't be a struggle. That's how you'll know the difference. And Eckhart Tolle calls it surrendered action. I love that, right? Doesn't even use the word work. We're going to get away. The work has a lot of negative baggage to it, right? So this is what it is, guys. This is what surrender is. This is the idea of yielding to the flow of life versus going against it, right? If you don't get God in flowing through you, if you don't get that divinity flowing through you, if you don't surrender to that now moment, to that what is, no matter what the circumstance or problem that you're in, then you're gonna have a tough going. You have a rocky way, guys. It's gonna be rough going for you. But when you get into that flow, then you're gonna flow right through it, right? Obstacles suddenly, walls dissolve, right? As opposed to trying to jump over things and battle through things, the walls and the obstacles dissolve. This is what it means to surrender. This is Tom Karen with the Be Something Wonderful Studio of Higher Consciousness, where we help you level up and become the best version of yourself. Guys, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and like and share our videos. That's how we get our message out. This is Tom. Until next time, with great love.